Mexico City is more than just the sprawling capital of Mexico. It stands atop the ruins of Tenochtitlan, the historic place where two powerful empires once clashed, the Spanish and the Aztecs. In the early 16th century, Tenochtitlan was the capital of the Aztec Empire and one of the largest cities in the world with as many as 300,000 residents. It was ruled by a powerful emperor named Moctezuma, who had expanded the Aztec Empire for hundreds of miles. The glory days of the Aztec Empire coincided with the period of exploration by Spain and its conquistadors. In 1519, one of these conquistadors, Hernán Cortés, began an expedition to Mexico, landing on Cozumel Island on the east coast. As Cortés pushed west, he met several native peoples on his way. The Tlaxcalteca had fought constantly with the Aztecs, and Cortés allied himself with them. This alliance would be crucial for Cortés, as the Tlaxcalteca helped him navigate the landscape, served as translators, and urged the defeat of Moctezuma. Moctezuma received reports of pale-skinned strangers as Cortés approached Tenochtitlan. Thinking the explorers might be an Aztec god king named Quetzalcoatl, Moctezuma sent the explorers lavish gifts. Cortés was motivated by these treasures and continued towards the city. He later wrote, "Moctezuma came to greet us, and with him some 200 lords, all barefoot and dressed in a different costume." The intricate city was teeming with turquoise and precious gems that the Spanish desperately wanted. After what appeared to be the start of an amicable relationship, Cortés imprisoned Moctezuma in an attempt to gain control of the city and its riches. After Moctezuma's imprisonment, the Spanish governor of Cuba, Diego de Velázquez, felt that Cortés had exceeded his authority and grew concerned Cortés may lose Tenochtitlan. He sent forces towards Tenochtitlan to arrest Cortés. Cortés and his soldiers set out to fight, leaving Tenochtitlan under the command of Pedro de Alvarado. Cortés defeated his foes and returned to Tenochtitlan to find that several Aztec nobles were killed. Alvarado had gotten wind of an Aztec attack and decided to take action. The fighting continued and Moctezuma was killed. With their leader dead and foreigners taking control of their city, the Aztec people fell into despair. One account describes it as if everyone had eaten stupefying mushrooms, as if they had seen something astonishing. Terror dominated everyone, as if all the world were being disemboweled. People fell into a fearful slumber. Cortés demolished Tenochtitlan in 1521. The Spanish continued to colonize Mexico, bringing with them the Spanish language, Catholicism, and a deadly disease called smallpox, which wiped out many native populations. This epic clash is visible to this day in Mexico City and elsewhere, not just through its historic ruins, but also its unique blend of Aztec and Spanish art, culture, and traditions.